6 dangerous locations in Russia to travel. Russia is the biggest country in the world. It's cold, gloomy, and everything here is trying to kill you, right? Not everything. We do have sharp-toothed animals, venomous snakes, or poisonous mushrooms, but the chance of facing them in real life is relatively small. However, it's always good to keep out of these 6 dangerous places. Karabash. The dirtiest place in the world, the city of Karabash in Chelyabinsk Oblast. This is the perfect example of what the pollution can do to the nature. Since 1974, copper smelting has destroyed the life within a radius of tens of miles. What used to be green, lush and fresh air is now orange water, cracked and lifeless land. Some say that if hell existed, this is how it would look like. The worst part of it is that the factories are still running and people still inhabit Karabash, despite being sick all the time. Norilsk. Located in the northern Krasnoyarsk territory, the city is another example of what human being is capable of. The metal-producing plants are running at full capacity. Some locals say that it smells black and the air tastes like sulfur. The factories in Norilsk smelt ore on a permafrost, producing over 40% of the world's palladium, nearly 1/5 of the Russian nickel and 2/3 of the copper. Acidic lake. Kamchatka Peninsula is one of the most intact places in Russia, with beautiful volcano ridges and clean air. But in the crater of the volcano called Mali Semyachik, there is a lake with a magical turquoise color. It is warm and pretty deep, but there is no way you can swim in there. The water is a mix of sulfur, fluoride, chloride and sulfate acids. It doesn't freeze up in the winter, and just placing your hand in the water can cause horrible chemical burns. And yes, the volcano is still active. Kolka Glacier. This deceptively quiet canyon in northern Ossetia became notorious in 2002, when the glacier, moving at the speed of over 100 km per hour, completely wiped out the village of Upper Karmadon. Exactly the same happened in 1902, when a large group of people and animals died, and their bodies were never found. No one really knows why it happened. Was the melting of the glacier inflicted by climate change? We don't know. The worst part of it is that the glacier starts moving so slowly that you might think you still have a chance to get out. Elbrus. Mount Elbrus, with its 5,600 meters, is the highest mountain in Europe. Just like the Everest, it is dubbed as a cemetery without crosses. Experts say that on average 15 to 30 people die each year trying to climb this extinct stratovolcano in the Caucasus. There is a rock that serves as a cemetery for everyone who died or disappeared while climbing the mountain. Some people tend to blame the deadly crevasses trapping the climbers, others the weather that can change any minute. Mountain Manaraga. No one of sound mind and memory will take you to the peak Manaraga in the northern Ural Mountains. Even though the peak is only 1,662 meters high, savvy climbers say that it welcomes no guests. Indigenous people used to consider it as an inanimate creature and worshipped it. They reportedly left several sacrificial stones in the mountain to find a common ground with it. The peak is still unclimbed, and some say that it has to do something with supernatural. That's all for today. If you have a question about Russia, ask me in the comment section. Don't forget to like and share this video on Facebook and subscribe to our YouTube channel.